Noosh told me all about the built-in adverbs, so I'm going to talk to you about some other adverbs that you can create to fill in for places where Cuba doesn't provide a handy abstraction. So, synthetic adverbs or design patterns for Cuba, or at least as much as we ever need. Synthetic and adverbs, by which I simply mean that these are not adverbs that come built into Cuba. To some people, the word adverb means exclusively the punctuation. To some, it means the punctuation and the small set of word adverbs, each over stand prior to each. And so, that's the vocabulary. So, these are like each over stand and so on. The basic idea is to capture common function patterns, common abstractions. Doing so helps you with readability and maintainability because you can identify you can separate the function that you're applying to your data structure from the pattern of the application. And then you can take that out and make a utility and document better and so on. So here are some basic examples that I use all the time. Filter. Line or XY is the most basic example. This is usually the first thing that goes in my personal library whenever I'm setting up a new instance of Q, in my Q.Q. It does go to the tin. X here is a function, Y is a data, a list generally. So return the elements of the list where function is true on the list. Slightly more advanced version, you may note that if you use this one on a dictionary, you'll get back only the value side, you won't get a dictionary. So this one works on either a dictionary or a list, returning a dictionary or a list as given. K-filter, filter on the key side of a dictionary. Map is for getting a dictionary when you didn't start with one. So I use this primarily for debugging, though it's occasionally useful for other things in production. Basically, you have something you need to run it on a list, you want to keep visible and available for future processing the original input, make a dictionary. So here's a dictionary of a list and a function run on the elements of the list. And here's a fancy version that returns a table instead of a dictionary. So here are some examples using these. Basic filter on some numbers. Here's a map that is so useful that I also build it into my libraries all the time. This simply counts all the tables in the current namespace. This is the same thing returning a table instead of a dictionary, so you can apply further selects to it. This is a little function that will convert all the symbols in a table into strings. So here we have, get the column names from the table from the meta where the type is a string. And here we have a map creating a dictionary of the column names on one side and the functional form for convert this column into a string on the other side for each of them. So this is an example of a place where I tend to use map in production rather than in debugging. It's very useful for creating attributes or additives for a functional update or query. Here are some more adverbs that go a little bit beyond what I call basics. Most of these apply to dictionaries. So typical map is a dictionary function on a dictionary applies to the value side, but sometimes you need to modify the key side too. So here's one that does that. You pass in a tuple of two functions. Sometimes you need to run one function that needs to have both the key and the value. So here's one that does that. Pass in a function and a dictionary. Sometimes you need to be able to add new pairs. For instance, you might have encoded keys that look something like foo underscore bar, and you want to split that into two foo and two keys, foo and bar. And this will let you do that. So decompose the dictionary. Flip it so you have a pair of lists, or list of pairs. Run the function dotted over each of those, raise it, flip it again, and make that back into a dictionary. And sometimes you just need to pretend there aren't any keys, typically on a table. So a related function is tapq.ft, although that handles it a little differently. That runs the function on the unseen version of the table rather than on the value side. And then you can go even further into specialization and write adverbs that are specifically to deal with very custom situations that you just might find yourself doing frequently. So here's one that applies a function to all of the columns of a table and then uses that to rename the columns. And the function I'm passing into it is to join foo underscore. So a common example you might need to do this is if you're LJing two tables together, LJing two tables together that have the same column names on the value side, then one of them is going to overwrite the other. And if the reason you're doing this is just going to compare them, then you need to rename at least one of them. And this will let you do that automatically. And finally, if you build other utility functions, then you can use these adverbs to help enhance them. So a commonly useful utility function would be this, x cap qdb key x, which lists either for a namespace or a dictionary or a directory on disk, lists the contents of their full path. So if x here is an apsin, the most useful case typically, then this will give you the full path of every file in that directory. But sometimes you don't want all the files, you want to filter that down. So here we've changed that so you can pass the filter function in X and the directory in Y, and now you can say something like this. Filtered contents of data for only files ending in CSV. So that's about it really. The slide will be going up on my blog and code version in my GitHub. Any questions?
We should do questions afterwards.
Oh, sure. Yeah.